heading back up to northeastern Ontario for another lodge experience at Lake Heritage Lodge and Resort near the area of Temagami. And this area is renowned for walleye, smallmouth, northern, you name it, man. It's got whitefish. So many opportunities, but it's a new place with some owners that just took over a couple years ago. So it's got some history, the place. It's got great family amenities, but the fishing is just lights out. Guys are saying that the walleyes average 19 to 21. Now, at Lake Heritage Lodge, they have opportunities to fish for walleye and smallmouth on remote lakes that see very little pressure. And you know me, I'm a bass hound. So any chance to fish big smallmouth with not a lot of pressure, usually I'm in. But the chance to get those 20 plus inch walleyes on lakes that nobody touches, and you say to yourself, okay, I'm gonna weigh the pros and cons here. What's the weather like? Is it ideal walleye weather? Like overcast, little chop, maybe a little rain in the air? Nope, exact opposite. Mother Nature says, we're gonna make it tough for you. Slick, 90 degrees, calm, bluebird skies, but right here, it doesn't matter because these walleyes have not been touched. That one is a walleye. Pretty sure it's, oh, that's a good fish. Yeah, that feels not bad. Brett, it might be, he's near the surface.
Yeah,
will those walleyes come up like that?
Sometimes, yeah. The mouth will be open.
Yeah. Where are you? Walleye? Walleye. Look at that.
Nice.
In the same spot.
Perfect.
Wow, eh? Nice.
That's a nice fish.
Yep. Wow, they do that nice color here, eh? Oh, boy. Nice. Beautiful colors. Look at those walleyes, man. Look at that. For good luck. That's being optimistic, folks. Here. Ready, walleye? Ready? He's like, wow. He let me go.
Yeah, right on.
On this trip, Brad said, you know, these walleyes move a lot on these back lakes. So we're going to use a little good old-fashioned blade and bead spinner rig, okay? With two little hooks, attach a good old-fashioned night crawler. He's got the ones called jiggernaut tackle. And it's real simple. Big, shiny blade that just spins. You attach a split shot about 20 inches above and attach it with a swivel so it doesn't twist up all your line. Cast out to the back of the boat and just slow power drift. And I know he knows what he's doing because a lot of times he's engaging, changing the speed, zigzagging the boat, and that makes a big difference than just putting the motor down, going in a straight line and hoping to get bit. A good guide, a good lodge owner knows that he wants to put his customers, and guys like myself, on fish fast. So moving back and forth, alternating the speeds, and getting to locations where those walleyes are.
Yeah.
Good one?
Yeah. That's a good one.
He stays down. Maybe yeah. It could be what we're thinking it is, right? Oh, nice walleye. Beautiful walleye. Wow, look at the colors on that thing, dude. You're right. Gorgeous, Brad. Oh, yeah. Gorgeous fish.
Like, that's about the average in here. Yeah, he's in this one. He's about 17 and a half.
Yeah, that's a releaser, huh?
Almost 18, yeah.
Yeah, beautiful.
Nice fish.
Oh yeah, let him go and swim, eh? Gorgeous walleye. Go on, fish.
Yeah,
lucky you. So we were throwing that little steel worm harness, okay, with the blade and the beads, I call it, night crawlers, but we're just going slow enough. Another option, especially these fish, like I said, they haven't seen a lot of baits or a lot of anglers, so they're somewhat naive, but you still gotta find them. So Brad's got these little reefs that come up, and they taper off down to like this real dark water. I would throw maybe like those little lucky shad by Strike King. Chartreuse, orange, bright colored bait. It looks like little shad bait. Deep nose, goes down about 8 feet. Just slowly working it. Every time he stops, it'll start coming up. That'll trigger those walleyes. There's a good fish right there, dude. Oh yeah, that's a good fish, dude. Oh yeah, that's a good fish. Oh yeah. I don't know if that's, whoa. Walleye or pike, but it's big. Oh yeah. Whoa. Might be a big Walter, I'm not gonna jinx it, but don't wanna force it now. Here we come. I can see the split shot. That is a big walleye. Yes. And there you go. Oh no.
He's in.
Okay. Oof.
Nice, Walter.
Oh, he's a nice one.
Beautiful fish.
Beautiful fish.
You're right about big, beautiful walleyes here. But to respect this fishery, you gotta let these big, beautiful fish go. Look at that. Just beautiful, golden Ontario walleye. Wow. Ready? Ready, big girl? Man, she earned her keep. What a scrap, man. What a time. Lake Heritage up here, they've got all these remote lakes and a couple short portages and just back and forth. Look at the conditions. You say prime walleye? Well, actually it's not, and we're not even fishing deep, but good reproduction, good respect for the fishery, catch and release, keeping those 16 and unders and stuff. You're allowed to keep one over, but I'm not going to do that. You know, I just want to have fun with them. And just slow power trolling, real easy. Split shot, come down to a little swivel so you don't twist up all your line. And Brad's got these little worm harnesses, single blade with the beads, that's it. And live bait, can't beat walleye fishing. Of course, Icon.